Very good afternoon friends, welcome to today's video lesson. Today I would like to discuss with you about workplace awareness part 2. Here, before that I would like to introduce myself friends. This is C.H. Narsaya, senior lecturer in English from Sanjay Gandhi Government Polytechnic, Adilabad. So in our previous video we were discussed in part 1 about workplace awareness and some parts, the areas to we were discussed. How we have to be aware of the workplace and how we have to be groom, how we have to mingle with the workplace and objectives. We were discussed how to focus on the other person and as well as how we have to listen and be concise whatever we speak with others. And timing is everything we were discussed, and choose a right delivery and right time, that is a very important in the workplace awareness. If you are assured to deliver a certain day and there deliver such a time, then perfect goods and whatever it may be, your services, whatever it may be, that is there is a time bound is very important friends. And ask questions if you unable to understand, and use your words to add advantage. You have certain words and use excuse me, how may useful, and how, and in a polite, in etiquette is very important. Dress expectations also very important in the organization. Any organization is very important. Dress expectations are there, and as well as workplace etiquette is important. How we have to work with other people, and how we have to be participate, and how we have to be move with the colleagues and friends and other subordinates and so and so. Be on time for the job, it's also very important points. Point phones and internet and electronic devices also very important. If while you are going for the interview or any work, keep your electronic guards in silent mode, like phone, or you have to be switch off it. That's very important. So as well as you have to be work is effective emails, how to send, how to receive effective emails. These emails are useful to be develop your communication skills with that day to day in your job with your colleagues and your organization and everything. So friends, using social media is very important. This is also one of the part in the social media. That social media plays a vital role, but you are not supposed to be use social media at the time of duty. You are meant for, you are supposed to work duty, but not for in the Facebook and Twitter and etc. So effective emails also, and a prompt spending sending promptly about emails also very important friends. Effective emails and written communication skills also very important. Understanding office politics also very important. We were discussed and how we have to be, how the office politics are common, but you have to cope with them. We have to mingle with them, and that's come. Stay in a subjective way, stay in a objective way, not in a subjective way. Be constructive, and this also very use. Work on your style. You should have a style of that. As well as next, manner and matter is also very important. Your manner is very useful to be success in your organization, at your workplace. That's very important. You have be polite and show respect towards your colleagues, and it is in a reciprocate way. And but your side is you have to be look after very important. Next, work on building positive relationships. Everywhere, wherever you work, you should have positive relationships are very important. Knowledge, your skills also very important. Now we are going to discuss to today, friends, the objectives of today's lesson, and learn workplace etiquette. First of all, we are going to be there. Workplace etiquette is very, very important. Identify the knowledge and skills and attributes, also very, very important. This also, this video lesson's objective is identifying knowledge. What type of knowledge we require, what sort of skills we require, what sort of attributes we require is very, very important at workplace. Building strong workplace relationships also important. This really helps you to work with peace of mind, and it leads to your success in your organization. And learn professional ethics also important. The ethics are very, very important in the wherever you work. Without ethics, professional ethics, you should not supposed to be survive. If you are in some position to be difficult, if you don't have ethics, nobody will not help you. So friends, ethics are very, very important. You be on time and respect others and dedicate for your work, and you feel that you are getting salary, and you have to serve them, and you have to love your profession, but not for money, not for job. Only you work for the job. Be professional. Develop the sense of responsibility towards the society also. It's also very, very important. Nowadays, the many corporate companies also, they are holding the responsibilities, social responsibilities. Here I would like to mention many senior actors and senior people are helping in the COVID situation, especially those who are feeling. I would like to mention Sonu Sood is a very, very excellent man. He's helping society, the poor, the cause of poor is working. He helped many persons, a dynamic person we have seen recently. He's a social responsibility, and as well as Bill Gates Foundation also helping for the people with their sharing their earnings. And recently, one big social media, Facebook, also giving many donations for the people for the cause of their development. And as well as Tata, we have to mention here that Tata is the biggest social responsible organization. They are from their starting, they are every year they are providing, they are contributing society. Much for education, and in many ways they are helping. So if Tata's are commercial, if they can't donate the money for the cause of poor people, I think he is the richest person in the world, not others. So, but he is a social responsibility. We have to feel we are getting from society, and we have to render the service for the society. That's very important. And as along with, if you have professional ethics, you are going to survive in this society, friends. So very, very important to build the relationships wherever you work. Friends may be with you, and your workers, your colleagues, like friends, invite them for your functions, and you have to attend. This is also useful to work relation. If you are in a position to be in some situation in difficulty, they are helpful. These relations are very, very useful. This you have to understand, friends. Etiquette is also very, very important. These are the objectives: professional ethics and social responsibility, and strong workplace relationships, and as well as you have to identify your knowledge and skills which are useful to workplace, and etiquette also very useful. Now, knowledge and skills and attributes useful at workplace, I am going to discuss here. What are the knowledge and skills? They are useful, friends. Very, very important. Communication skills are very, very indispensable. If you are sound at communication, you can build the strong relationship, good relationship with the society. Or else you are not supposed to be success. The communication skills like listening, you have to listen about the problems of your colleagues, and they have to be listen about you. That is very, very useful. And speaking skill is one of the important skills. and very very useful. You have to be maintain that is as well as the writing skills also very very important, or else you should not be surviving this job. So friends, you have to you learn the skills like listening. First listen before the speak, listen properly, or else you should not survive in that sector. Listening, speaking and writing are very very indispensable in the workplace. That's next. Analytical and research skills are very very useful. You have to analyze the work wherever you are working. Whatever you are working, first you analyze and then research on that, and that skills are useful to be enhance your work skills and to be happy at your workplace. So analytical skills are to what extent is important, and you have to research on it. First of all, the flexibility and adaptability is very very important. You have to be flexible according to with your sometimes your boss may invites you, orders you to sometime day, can you better to come one day on Sunday, can you work place there? You actually Sunday is a holiday maybe, but if you follow the your boss and your officer's order, then that leads to be some kind of positive shade and area about you. Sometimes if you need any kind of emergency work on working day, you can apply a leave on the day. You can get a leave on the day easily. It means is a dedicative person. You prove yourself if you are is flexible, is mold, is helpful, and is sincere. If you feel they feel you are able to be work in the workplace. It's adaptability. You feel that is my organization, my work. If without this organization, I am not able to be survive. This organization is mine. I have to feel these are my friends. This is my organization is like my family. You feel that is my family. It's our family. That's very very important. Next, you learn that abilities first. Flexibility is very very important, friends. So friends. As well as flexibility and adaptability, that is very very important. So friends, you are able to be survive, and next you are able to be prosper. There you can work. Light both appropriate screen both light next. So friends, you are able to be work then you have friends. The analytical skills and research skills also very very important, whether it is useful or not, whether it is applicable or not. You have to be think and you have to adapt the work. It's my organization, it's my work. You have to feel that. So then you should flexibility is very very important according to situation. There is a little bit you have to go think out of the box also important. You have to think the employer's side, not for your side. If you're able to think about the employer side, you can be a good employee and you can work peacefully in the workplace also. Adaptability is very very important. Interpersonal adaptability is also very very important. Interpersonal skills, abilities also very very important. Interpersonal abilities also very very important, friends. If you are not that ability is very very abilities, adaptability and interpersonal abilities are, if you have, you can survive. That you should have the good relations, warm relations, healthy relations with your colleagues, with your boss and your followers, your neighbors. That is very very important to survive in the workplace. So friends, if you must have possess it, and I would like to remind you friends, ability to make decisions and solve the problems, that is one of the skills you require to be work at workplace. You have to take decisions, make decisions, or decision making skills are very very important at workplace. If anything happens, any adverse may happen, then immediately you have to take the quick decisions. The quick decision taking making power is very, very important. If any problems arises, you have try to solve it. Try to solve the problems. Decision making and problems solving is a skill, is an ability. It requires is indispensability. It is a mandatory skill for the employee. These type of employees requires for any organization. Employers also prefer this type of those who have analytical skills, those who are able to take decision making skills, and those who are able to solve the problems, those who have the interpersonal skills and abilities, those who are flexible. These type of employees are required nowadays. They are hiring. That's those who have analytical skills and research skills. In the some organizations, of course, some make pose questions. Though that person who how is working is not adaptable, is not flexible. How he, but though he is surviving, how long? Sometimes some day will comes for that. But that time you are going to be scapegoat or you are going to be victimized. So friends, you must possess the. You must possess that skills, interpersonal abilities, very, very important. Decision making skills, you have to acquire. The problems are common. The problems you have to be solved. Try to be. Ability to plan. If you are some work, any kind of work assigned you, you have to be plan how you are going to be execute, how you are going to implement the plan work. That is important. Planning ability is very, very important. How that you have to be make yourself a plan and make it success. That is also important. Next, organize and prioritize work also important. According to which is first and which is next, the priority is you should know that priority. So last work is first and first work last. It means you don't know the organizing skills. They feel that you don't have prioritizing skills. These you must possess, friends. Ability you should have, you should plan. Very, very important that you plan. Next, ability to wear multiple hats also important. Nowadays, employer always seeks, my employee should be able to execute, he should be able to work multitask. You should possess, my employee should possess multitasking ability. So at a time you should play many roles. If your organization, someday your servant your subordinate may not come, you have to be arrange all those things. And if your boss may not attend, you have to be take the responsibility about all the things and multiple hats according to situation. According to plan, you have to be work. If you are in boss seat, like a boss. If you are working yourself, be a subordinate. But be able to be wear multiple hats. That is very important. We have to, and interpersonal abilities along with these multiple hats, skills also important. Multitasking ability is important. And priority, you should an employer should know priority. What is important? Attending parties or attending duties which is important. Support. Vary from person to person, but duty is divine. If you're feeding us, you have to feed. You have to one day, you can go and you are sometime after your completion of duty, you can go and you can wish if you have any party or even function. There they can understand. But if you are sincere about your work, if you are able to do that multitasking, you can survive. Even though recession time, some people, those who are escapers, now the trend economy is in a reversal position. For many companies, they are try to remove the jobs according to checking according to their position, financial position, due to COVID, and their business graph was fallen due to decrease their loss. They are removing employees, many employees. That time, those who are irresponsible, those who are not multitasking, those who are stubborn, those who are not flexible and adaptable. That time they take the chance to be these type of irregular candidates are going to be removed from the jobs. That time they have to come on the roads, and their family will be thrown into the problems. That's why be sincere about work. That's important. We have the good communication skills with your colleagues. Next, I would like to discuss with you leadership and management skills, also very, very important. If you are working, you should be a leader of an organization. That's why I would like to discuss. If you are working with a team, you should be a team player. You have to mix, you have to mingle with them, you have to cope with them, you have to motivate them, you have to be a role model, and you have to be idealist. If you are, any mistake has been occurred, you have to admit them. But a leader should always motivate. He has to be lead the role of exiled role, and it means he should be moral. He should be role model for his members. My boss is working, my friend is working, why can't I? You have to create the position for your colleagues, your followers, your team members. So sometimes leadership quality, that is, you have to be, if they are working in an organization, if they are working sometimes, you have to offer some kind of sort of tea or something. If they are working some more hours, if you want to extract some more work, offer a tea or coffee. Sometimes if they want one working 2-3 more hours, offer a evening snacks or something. That's a good way to be extract work from the employees. That's a leadership, that is a leadership quality, management quality, that is called management skill. If someone is interested, you on the day you have to extract some work. And if someone feeling uneasy, you permit him to leave the office 1 hour early. Oh, you can go. I look after the work. Nothing to worry. Take the rest. It means if you manage this kind of, you will win the trust of your team. They follow you. My boss is good. My boss can understand me. He's like a friend. You should be a founder, you should be a role model like this. Management leadership qualities are good at workplace. That in the workplace to be survived. Next, attention to detail. Whatever is going to happen, how to be write a notepad and you have to follow it. Attention is very, very important on duty. Some you are working, especially in the, if you are working machinery, in some important things, you should be attentive mind. If you are absent your mind, sometimes that leads to accidents. That accident is that cause of accidents. Loss of big loss, that leads to big loss. So you are always be attentive and be a leader, and you should have management qualities also, skills. Next, multiple hatting skill also you requires. Next, self-confidence, first of all. If you are assigned some work, new work, don't lose confidence. Don't say, I'm sorry, sir, if I'm unable to work. This, don't say like this. Self-confidence, okay, I can, sir. I'll try myself, sir. My level best. If I need and if I have any queries, I'll approach you, sir. Please guide me, suggest me, sir, how to think, sir. This way you have to be. Self-confidence is the biggest weapon to be. Achieve any kind of target. It's confident. Be confident, friends. For students, friends, you be confident when you are working. Confidence, first of all, you should have, if you have confidence, you can make them to work. Any organization. If you are cultivating some sort of any craft, so it will be yields good and it I'm get the profit. You should have. But you should know what extent I'm hard to do this, that's I'm doing. This way is not. Confidence is important. Self-confidence is the biggest, you can success. If you possess it, you can success. You can achieve the success. Public speaking skills also very, very important in the workplace. you sometimes you are supposed to be speak the group of people, and sometimes you are invited to speak in a meeting or ceremonies. There you have to be speak according to the situation, according to the event. You have to be congratulate, and you have to be convey your message to be that should be a memorable message to be, and remember everyone. This is a public speaking skills. Public speaking skills are very, very important. Especially the leaders, managers require public speaking skills. If your team is working in the ground and the ground level, your inspiration is very, very important. If they are a fail, I think you are speaking, you are not feeling inspiration, inspiration in your team. So especially political leaders, they require the public speaking skills. Here I would like to mention the public speaking skills like KCR. KCR used to speak sometime in the public meetings. His public speaking skills are excellent. You can mobilize with, you can inspire the single speech. So you can defend the opposition. But what extent, but the skill is like that. He can say true is true or false also true like that. He can manipulate. He can say with a confident way his public speaking skills are to be grab attention of the people. So tactfulness also very important. If you are working, you need according to situation a tactfulness is important. But without having tactfulness, you should not survive. Situation based on you have to work. The tactfulness. Next, creativity. Coming to next point, creativity. Creativity is very, very indispensable nowadays. The employer requires creativity too. He has to be give a sort of novelty for every day. If traditionally your product may comes in the same model, when you it cannot attract the customers, you cannot grab the attention of. Though our business, here it is, we have to be think of, especially in the automobile field. If you are working as an automobile field employee, every year they used to bring their, a little bit of changes and models, bring it to model, new models. They with their creativity to be attract the customers. But though that is a successful model, every year they used to bring a little bit of changes, some variants they used to be. And tag for that model, especially in the two-wheeler and four-wheeler companies, they appoint us the creative people over them in the manufacturing and to develop their business to in the multifold, multiply way, they request the creativity to explain that. Ethics and integrity are also very, very important. Already we were discussed in a previous video. The ethics are important for employers. He has to follow times. He should. Our time is the everything, and he has to be honest. He should not supposed to be steal or something. He has to protect the wealth of his company, and integrity also working with that people. His team is integrity. But these are the two biggest weapons to be successful for the employee. So don't lose ethics first of all. Whichever is feeding you, whichever job is feeding you, don't cheat that job, don't do the company, cheat that company. If you request, if you have any demands while appraising time, you can approach them. But in case of duties, but don't compromise. Don't lose the ethics. You should not reveal the models. Some companies, some creative people, they are working some organization. They used to leak some kind of creative models for the opponent companies to getting some kind of bribes. This is nothing but losing ethics. Integrity also important. You have to be work for your company's integrity. Strong work ethics are important. If you are in the work, at work, you should be work. That's all. You are not supposed to be bunk for that work and attending and bunking, rooming, going outside and having cup of something, the gap period you can. But the strong work ethics, if your work is for 8 hours, You are supposed to be work for 8 hours, that's all. Or else, see, these are called strong ethics. If you are in college, you should be. If you are in duty, you should be. This is the model. You should feel moral ethics is my duty is to be served to my company. It is helping me and my family to be lead. That is strong ethics, dignity, but ability to accept, learn from criticism. If you are going to give any kind of new work, you accept it. If you do any mistake, you have to admit your mistakes. Learn from criticism. Sometimes while you are working sincerely, you are working many hours for company, I think you will receive little bit of criticism from the those who are escaping from duties. That there you should don't bother with them. You will ready to receive that such a kind of criticism, but you have to learn from criticism. I am working for my duty, my company and my organization. Why this is I have to do? Now don't care them to check out that people. You should ready to accept mistakes. You admit from mistakes and ability to accept that criticism also. Don't bother about that. But you should sales and marketing skills also very very important. If you are working as a sales manager, how you have to promote the sales? You have to tell the qualities and a special comparing with the other models, the qualities and specifications about your qualities, you have to tell the marketing field. Very very important. Here I would like to mention one movie in Rajendra Prasad. He's working like a sales. He tries to sell papers, but similar the same way. But he's in a poor condition, or say he wants to sell something, papers something. Same way, one boy is about 10 to 12 years, the boy is also selling. So Rajendra Prasad approaches madam, this is wood dolls and this is some doll, but it's very tasty. Nobody is not buying. Immediately the boy, you are coming, say you are selling it. Let me show how it has to sell. That boy asked him, please observe me. The boy said, he went and madam, this is 10 rupees madam. If you have money or also you take it, next time day you can give this 10 rupees. Oh, this for 10 rupees I wanted it. Nothing to worry. One 10 rupees and she was buyer that product. Immediately, madam, you can take one more also, madam. Okay, that is. Means the boy's marketing technique strategy is different. For any cost he wanted to sell, he wants to convince the people. The convincing is very very important. If you are not able to deliver your product on time, you have to be ask to apologize, sir. Sorry for delay, the cause of delay, that's important. Any marketing field, if you are assured to deliver the any two-wheeler or four-wheeler on sort of one day, if you are not able to deliver, you have to convince the customer something, you have to make them better. That's sales and marketing skills are very very important. Marketing, computer and electronic skills also very very important. You should be able to use the computer and electronic gadgets also according to situations. If you are working in an organization, sometimes you have to work from home. Sometimes you online you have to do business. Electronic gadgets also. Sometimes now everyone, due to this epidemic situation, everyone is conducting virtual meetings, virtual rallies, and business virtual meetings in the business also. You with the electronic gadgets, you have to be joined with them. The Google Meet or some kind of any kind sort of meetings are there. If you are able to utilize it, you can. Mathematics and programming knowledge also very very important for you. That's also next in the workplace. In the workplace, two kinds of skills are important. There are two kinds of skills, are the technical skills and soft skills. There are two types of skills out there. Knowing how to accomplish specific tasks like cooking, computer, programming or teaching are called technical skills. This is a technique. The computer program is a technique, teaching also technique, teaching techniques we have to learn. Cooking also technical. Everybody cannot cook, not taste. Specifically to be accomplished these skills. They relate to particular occupation. You may have learned technical skills from past work experience, school or training somewhere. You are going to be trained. Somehow you are taught somewhere in school and some training, what they have taught. These skills are often included in the job. Our listeners today describe the tasks of position. So it's very, very important. Next example, so build a cabinet. So it's also very important. You should have one kind of cabinet. You need them, your supporters and something. You have to work that. Next, read an image also. What is going to be image? That image and operate the equipment. How to be operate that equipment, your skills also important. Paint a portrait also important. What kind of portrait you are going to be? That's why I'll do this kind of visualize the work first of all. Visualize what is going to happen after your marketing, after your work. If you are preparing a recipe, that is how the taste will be. You have to visualize that this taste is wonderful. My recipe is excellent. You have to be same. Next, write a computer code also important. Teach a lesson. Everyone, you teach something lesson, you should be unique. You should make them to understand the people, to grab the attention according to the situation. Investigate a specific question also important. And the next, what is going to be, how I have to be handle it. Self products to customers also very, very important. Next, employers also want to be employed, who fit in and get along well in the workplace. Who will fit and who will not, who will along with come with our organization for how long they will come out, they will check employer. Some people they used to change repeatedly they change their jobs for 3 months, one job company, one company, this kind of. Can they look after that consistency in their work, in their employees, that they think of like that. They request the soft skills, and these are also valuable. That soft skills are often in a reason employers decide whether to keep or promote an employee. Some soft skills can be taught in school, but most of you learn in the everyday. Some of the schools, some skills, soft skills are this way they will try. But in day-to-day life, we can learn some soft skills in life and can improve any time. For example, good communication skills. Of course, communication skills generally we develop in our schooling and as well as our family and with friends, peer group, and especially much in the schooling. But sometimes there was a gap was occurred, you are not able to communicate properly. With a little effort, with some kind of conscious effort, you can acquire, you'll become a good communicator. There are many organizations now outside to be improve our communication skills. You can take their guidelines and how we have to communicate with the people. This guidance will help you. Critical thinking, how you have to think in a critical thinking skills, you can then approaching some people, the intellectuals, and how I have to execute this work. And the working well in a team also, if you work in a team, that you will be trying to do some kind of skills. Self-motivation is the biggest motivation, biggest success. For any cost, I have to work. For I can work, I can improve my communication, I can discharge my duties effectively with my colleagues. You feel, if you have such kind of self-motivation, you can be right. You can be work. You can work effectively. Being flexible, first of all, you should be flexible. You should mingle with your team. You say be a leader, be a member of a team player. First of all, be a guide, be a follower, not be a manager. Like a leader, not a manager. Manager says you can go and do this work. Leaders, we can go and we can do this. So, in any to be success, be a leader, not to be a manager. Of course, managers or bosses, orders, leaders, they work with us and with bosses also. Being flexible, that is important. Sometimes we, you should have that flexibility. Sometimes we cannot attain something. That time you should have flexible. Though that time is not convenient for us, we have to change our timings sometimes. Determination, you have to be flexible. So determination and persistence also very, very important, friends. You have to be, think of it, you first to decide well in advance. And persistence, how to be work for any cost, how to success, how to reach my target, how to do this business, how to acquire my communication skills. This way you should have determination. Being a quick learner, you learn the quick. You, of course, everyone is not familiar with everything, but if you're a quick learner, you can learn something. Be a quick learner, you learn all the qualities to be a future good employee. Good time management is also important. Be on time. You have to go duty on time. Soft skills. Now coming to next point, soft skills. There are some skills and qualities employers seek in their employees, regardless of position. Anyone, that position may be from office subordinate to office higher position, MD. Everyone needs soft skills. The position is not important. Everyone requires the soft skills. There are called soft skills, and they include that interpersonal skills also. How you have to mingle with the friendly, how you have to work with a harmonious way, that's important. And attributes you to need to success in the workplace, they are also commonly referred as a professional skills. Professional skills are important. Soft skills, those that are, these soft skills also professional skills, nothing but professional skills. Those that maintain healthy workplace also very, very important. Next, hard skills. In addition to soft skills, there are other more tangible or technical that most projects require to do job. You will need both soft skills and hard skills for any job. And it's important to show the employer that you have to be combination of hybrid skills, all these skills, soft skills and technical skills. They need to, when they are applying and interviewing, the jobs are also very, very important. Next, communication skills. Communication skills, the ability to communicate effectively, both verbally in writing also. Verbal and non-verbal, both skills are important. It's both essential for rare, but having everyone verbal, non-verbal communication skills, having a single person, it's rare. But everyone should possess. Nowadays, employer seeking more that kind of qualities from his employee. Those with strong communication skills are in high demand nowadays. Those who have good communication skills in that market, there is a high demand too. Why? Because those who have good communication skills, they can handle his job with perfectly. Demand is a hand. Regardless of the job of industry nowadays, it's very, very important. If you have communication skills, you can manage everything, anything. The industry is depend on the communication, your pursuing skills, and the motivating skills to be somewhere. So if you have this communication skill, you will have ample opportunities, abundant opportunities you will have in the industry. You need to be able to be communicate successfully with the employees, managers and customers in person, and very in a person, single, online, in writing, and or even in the phone, the various, such a kind of skills are required. Or else, if you don't possess these skills, I think the business will be damages. So, these skills are indispensable for employees. Here, I would like to discuss with the next interpersonal skills. Interpersonal skills are also known as the people skills. This is called in the people skills, or the skills you are used to interact and engage with the others. Many are hired hourly based, like purely on their ability to be connect. How they are able to connect with the people, interpersonal skills can be trump the other skills employers are seeking. Interpersonal skills, how you are able to be interact with the people. So be sure yours are up to par, on par with the, I think, I hope that you should possess the skills of known people. This is a very, very interactive English is very important. Leadership skills, I would like to discuss next. The leadership skills are very, very important. When companies hire for a leadership roles, they seek the employee that can successfully interact with the employees also. My leader, my head should be, he has able to interact with the remaining employees. He has to cope and he has to manage them too. He has to motivate them to work effectively. Colleagues and customers, even if you are not applying for management jobs, though you are not management job, but you, they see, they expect from the employee, my employee should work as a leader. He has to convince his colleagues, the co-workers and colleagues. Leadership is a valuable skill to bring to the employer. You bring to the employer is a valuable skill. Many companies prefer to be promoted from the within. If the person possesses the leadership skills, they promote them as a lead, as they will get promotions and within. And in such way, they often look for a strong leadership qualities. Who will possess strong leadership qualities? Even when hiring for entry level positions, they are seeking whether my future employee may be possessed leadership skills or not, they are thinking. Next, positive attitude also very, very important. Attitude may not be everything, but attitude, positive attitude important, but it's extremely valuable. Employers want employees that be positive even in stressful and challenging circumstances also. The positivity denotes your level of reliance. Very, very important. Resistance. And the employers who want to be hired applicants with a can't do attitude. I can't do attitude. They are hiring like that. Attitude that are flexible, dedicated, and willing to contribute extra effort to get the job done in the face of challenges nowadays. That is very important. Every positive attitude, very, very important. So those who will possess the positive attitude, they are going to be successful. Okay. Next, friends, we are going to discuss after teamwork. Teamwork is also very, very important. The job employs, he has to work in the team, and he should work as a team player, and he has to cooperate with work with others. They don't want to employ difficult with work. Those who are not able to work as the team, that kind of going to be removed. Interviewing, sure that share examples how you work and in the previous team, and what are your relationships. They will ask in the teamwork. Indicates ability of collaborate, whether you have any kind of quarrels with your previous team. They think that he's not a team player, he cannot collaborate with his team. The variety of people, they think that technical skills is you need to will vary of the course depending on the job. However, the most option positions require the least some technical skills. Minimum technical skills are very important. It includes experience using industry software also. We completing higher level of education or being experienced in highly specific tasks. More important skills. These days technology shapes the world, and we are living in the technology world. That's why many people, employers want be people they hire to come already equipped with certain technical skills. They don't want to train, already they must possess it. And social media skills also important. If you are working in a specific field of involves the communication, you like to be need to sharpen your social media skills. This does not just mean to be learning how to use the platforms, though you should also know how to use social media sites effectively. And employers often ask you to demonstrate sometimes that you are the power users, how you are able to use of a particular social media channel. Learning how to get your message across the social media will help you can attract the candidate also. So the social media skills are very, very important to promote their business. Like the computer skills, minimum computer skills are very, very important skills. Almost all in any job, your most of the jobs requires the computer literacy. Everyone seeks the computer knowledge, whether using Word, MS Word, Excel, or some any other advanced software. The problem solving skills also very, very one more point we are going to discuss. It seems to be little like the analytical or interpersonal skills, but problem solving often considered a separate skills. I think some critical, some people have specific skills that some people possess that. Troubleshooters they are called. Every company seeks the troubleshooters. You may have to deal with them problems arising that request to quick response and resolutions, being able to be think on your feet. Solve the problems the moment notice, and an important asset every employer longs for. So these are the things, skills we were discussed, friends. These are the skills, soft skills and hard skills, the knowledge skills and attributes we were discussed. We saw very, very these skills are we were discussed, friends. And I think hope you might have understand these this video. Thank you very much. Thank you listening for my video. Thank you very much.